All right, with the triple digit temperatures, there's still lots of things to do to beat the heat and enjoy Wildlife World Zoo. So joining us this morning is a hairy armadillo. Have you ever seen one of these? Kristy, join us bringing it in this morning. This is Tank, right? Perfect name for the little guy.
I know, it's a very fitting name. And this is Tank. He is a big hairy armadillo. And it's easy to see how they get that name. He's covered in fur, and he's a lot hairier than some of the related species of armadillo.
And these are the bigger ones too, right?
That's right, yeah. He's a lot bigger than most of the armadillos you're gonna find out there. And right now, I've put him in a little tub with some enrichment in here for him, some of his favorite treats, some straw for him to crawl around in.
This is not straw, this is
hay. Oh, hay.
I only know that because I grew up on a farm.
Yeah, some hay. And these guys are great diggers. So in the wild, they have very sharp claws that they're going to use to dig into the earth. Mm-hmm. And they have special membranes inside their nose that's going to allow them to absorb oxygen from the earth.
That's interesting.
Yeah, don't get a bunch of dirt
up
their nose.
Stay cooler by digging under the ground, right?
Absolutely. So these guys go underground to avoid the hot temperatures and predators.
Is that where they spend most of their time?
They do, and it depends a lot on the year and the climate above ground. These guys are very adaptable, and that's a reason their species are doing so good right now. They're very adaptable to the climates, and they're also very adaptable as far as their diet goes. They can eat a variety of different things, but their diet's mainly gonna be a variety of different bugs.
So Mark is shooting this on our Facebook Live, and he was asking before this segment, these are different than the ones you see in Texas that roll up, correct?
That's right. So yeah, a lot of people, when they think of armadillos, they think of the ones that roll up like little roly-polies.
Right.
But these guys, actually, what they'll do when they feel threatened is they'll hucker in a lot like a tortoise does. So they're gonna pull their limbs in, tuck their head down, and they have bony plates on the top of their body that's gonna protect them very well.
He is really interesting looking. He looks like a little busybody. Are they always like real busy doing things?
Yes, he is a busybody. He spends a lot of time sleeping, but the second he wakes up, he is on the move, and he's part of our education department, so people can come out to our wildlife encounter shows, and he'll run up on stage, he runs back and forth, he'll run in front of people, so people can get up close and personal with
Tank. And I love that he loves Fruit Loops. That's awesome. We could hang out for a while.
Yeah.
So the kids get to touch him out at the Wildlife World Zoo, and of course, you got everything else going on out there right now.
That's right. So if you come to our safari camp, kids can touch him. We have another camp opening up in July. So if anyone's interested, you can go to our website for details.
Kristy, thank you. We always love the animals you bring in, especially this little guy. Gina, is he cool looking?
He is. He needs a little lotion, though, I'm thinking. He's a little scaly.
Yeah, he is. He's a little character.
Thanks, Scotty. Really appreciate that. Let's